بارئ الخلائق أجمعين باعث الأنبياء والمرسلين ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين لا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين واللعن الدائم على أعدائهم أجمعين أما بعد فقد قال الله عز وجل في كتابه الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم من كان يريد العزة فلله العزة جميعا إليه يصعد الكلم الطيب والعمل الصالح يرفعه آمنا بالله صدق الله العلي العظيم صلوات When we look at things around us, we give things value and worth. For example, we say this property is worth this much, or this car is valued at this much. In fact, even people, we say this person is worth this much, this basketball player or this football player, that's his value. However, there's one question that's important, and that is, how much do we value ourselves? How much worth do we give to ourselves? In other words, what self-image do we have about ourselves? You can call it self-esteem or izzatun nafs. How much izzatun nafs do we have? And this is a very important question that inshallah, today and tomorrow, I'd like to address this topic of how we perceive ourselves, how much worth and value we give to our own selves. So the first thing we want to look at is why is this so important? Why is it so important to give ourselves and to have a positive image of ourselves and to have this self-esteem? If you look at into psychology and many studies that are conducted on this topic, you find that self-esteem is very important. For example, a person with self-esteem, a person who has value for himself, will have very noble and high goals. And this is something that we all want, especially as parents. We want this for our children. I remember once I had a child with me, a 9-year-old, and we were in a cemetery visiting some of the greatest of ulama. And I turned to this child and I told him, inshallah, one day you'll be like him, like this great scholar. And he looked at me saying, no. And I felt sad. Why? Why don't we as children, as parents, as a community, have a good image of ourselves? Give ourselves worth and value that we can aim really high. Why is it that when I say to youth that you can be the next Ayatollah Bahjat, and you find this doubt that that's too high for me? Self-esteem is very important. It allows us to aim really high, achieve high goals. Self-esteem and having a positive view of ourselves also helps us generally in relationships. Healthy relationships happen when we have a good image of ourselves, a positive value of who we are. Emotional well-being, staying away from mental health issues, is also linked with a good sense of value of who we are. Battling peer pressure, when we're faced with challenges from other cultures or perhaps other religion, in a society or in a place where we stand alone, standing for our values and our principles, it requires a strong amount of self-worth, of self-esteem, to be able to go against the pressure, to go against the current. And so you realize this is very important. In a very beautiful story in the Holy Quran, the story of Talut, you find that when the Bani Israel asked their prophet that we want somebody to help us conquer the lands, Allah appoints Talut for them. And you know the story. They go on a journey with Talut, and Talut places for them a few tests. The first test is that they come to a river, whether they're thirsty or not, whether they're tired or not, they're not allowed to drink from the water of the river except a handful. And then after this very difficult test, they enter the land and they come across a huge army. The army of Goliath, huge. These individuals with a very strong image of themselves, a positive image of themselves, a strong self-esteem. What do they say? كَمْ مِنْ فِئَةٍ قَلِيلَةٍ غَلَبَتْ فِئَةً كَثِيرَةً بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. That many times, with the permission of Allah, a small group of people has conquered and defeated a big group of people. See that strength and power they have? It's beautiful. It's very beautiful when you have this very strong self-worth, this image of yourself that you are able to conquer this big army. At the beginning of Islam, you find many of the companions, they were like this. They faced a people that would mock them, laugh at them, harm them, torture them, but they stood strong. Why? Because they had a strong sense of worth. Their self-image was very positive. There's a hadith that's very beautiful. You know, sometimes when you read hadith, all the hadith are beautiful, but some of them are gold. I want to share one of these hadith, golden hadith. And there's so much we can say about this hadith. Amir al-Mu'minin Ali ibn Abi Talib says, Man karumat alayhi nafsuh. Whoever has self-worth, who has ikram to his own self, who considers himself in a positive way, a self-esteem, man karumat alayhi nafsuh, lam yuhinha bil ma'asiyah. This person will not degrade himself with sins. In other words, when we go towards sins, when we degrade ourselves and lower ourselves to do things that we know are wrong, it's because we don't value ourselves. We don't have enough respect for ourselves. We don't have a good image of ourselves. We don't think that we're good enough. We don't think that we can aim really high and achieve some amazing things in this world. We don't think that we're amazing. And that's why we let ourselves do things that are wrong. Amir al-Mu'minin says, Man karumat alayhi nafsuh. In another hadith, Hanat alayhi dunya. Somebody who has self-esteem would consider that this world as petty. Would consider this world as unworthy. I'm greater than this world. You want me to do a haram business? Really? $2 million? I'm greater than this. I'm bigger than this. You see how this self-esteem saves a person from doing haram, considers this world as lower than him. The opposite. Amir al-Mu'minin says, Man hanat alayhi nafsuh. A person who doesn't have self-esteem, a person who doesn't consider himself important, فَلَا تَرْجُوا خَيْرًا. You cannot have too much hope in goodness from him. Doesn't believe that he's good, doesn't have a positive image of himself, what can you hope from him? He might betray you. You might see evil from him. Very normal for him to do things that are wrong because he doesn't consider himself important. So you see how amazing and how important it is for us as individuals to ensure that we have a good image of ourselves. We build our self-esteem. We have this ikram for ourselves. And that we inculcate this in our family members, in our children. We consider ourselves amazing and we count our children amazing. And if you turn around and tell me, but Miqdad, what if this is arrogance? This is pride. Then we turn to the Ahlul Bayt. Imam As-Sadiq alayhi salam says, again, a principle. He's establishing for us a reality of how things are. He says, "Ma min rajulin takabbara aw tajabbara." There is not a single person who is arrogant, except that illa lidhillatin wajadaha fi nafsi. Except that inside him, he counted himself as dhalil. He found himself weak and low. He had a very negative image about himself. That's why he had to tell others, "I'm better than you." That's why he had to be arrogant and say, "You're worse than me, I'm better than you." Why did he go into arrogance? Because inside him he was weak, he felt low. And obviously the opposite. Somebody who feels very important, who knows that he's important, who has self-esteem, doesn't need to go and show off or be arrogant. He'll walk on the earth very humble. He knows his value. He knows his worth. He knows he has a good image about himself. So, to wrap up this first part of the discussion, we realized what izzatun nafs is, this izzah that we need to have, this self-esteem that we need to have, and how important it is for our lives. It allows us to have a good goal. It allows us to build strong relationships. It allows us to be mentally, emotionally stable. And allows us to be spiritually strong, stay away from sins, stay away from arrogance. Generally, self-esteem is very important for a believer. So now we know that it's very important. Let's talk about the source of this worth. There's three sources that I'd like to talk about today that could lead us to build an image of ourselves, that we use these things to build our self-esteem. However, these all three of them are an imaginary self-esteem. They're fake self-esteem. It has no value. And so all the benefits that we talked about, if our self-esteem is built upon these three, then it has no worth. The self-esteem has no worth. It would not lead you to what we talked about right now. The first one. When our self-esteem and our image of ourselves is built on our identity that comes from the work that we do. You see, many times our identity rotates around what we do. Have you noticed how when you ask a child about his future, of what work he's going to do, you ask him, "What would you like to be?" What do you mean, what would you like to be? The question is, what would you like to do? But you say, no, what would you like to be? Why is it that work and what we do in our lives to earn an income has become part of our identity? And it leads us to believe that our identity and who we are and our image of ourselves is built and focused around what job we do, what employment we have. And so when we have certain employment or a certain type of job, we consider ourselves more important than others. I'm a doctor. I'm a lawyer. I'm this. When this becomes my identity of who I am, if you ask who am I, rather than saying other things, we say, this is my work. You find that your identity is rotating around your work. In this sense, your self-esteem also goes back to this. Your worth goes back to your work. And then if, God forbid, you lose your work, what happens? Depression. I'm worth nothing. I'm now worth nothing. Why are you worth nothing? I lost my job. Since when does job make you who you are? When does a job make you give you value? So we have to be careful. Our self-esteem and the image of ourselves cannot go back to what work we do. That's the first point. The second point. At times, things that we possess, material things that we own, also form our identity. If I have a big car, a very expensive, posh car, if that leads me to think that I am better or I have a greater sense of who I am, that's a fake self-esteem. And unfortunately, the world we live in, the material world that we live in, is based around this idea that the more you own, the more you're successful in your material dimension, the better you are. Marketing today, how does marketing work? How does advertisement work today? It sells a product to you in a way that if you don't have this product, you're not worth it. You've missed out on life. Bro, you're missing out. If I have it, I'm more worth it. I have more value. That watch that I wear, that purse that I carry, those shoes that I'm on my feet, they give me worth and value. When I'm sitting behind that posh car and I've got my hands on the steering wheel and I feel I'm important, I feel I've got a lot of value and worth because of what I drive, that's a fake sense of self-esteem. In fact, you can go and research this. It's there online. Psychological studies on this has shown that those who link themselves to link their self-esteem to their material possession and link their identity to what they possess and count what they possess because they possess as more valuable, giving to the identity, in fact, will become very weak. Will lose out on many different things, including their emotional and mental well-being. Because there is no reality to it. That really doesn't give us worth. What we own doesn't really give us worth. Today we have it, tomorrow we lose it. And this is something very important, really important. As a community, we should be very careful. The image that we build of ourselves should never go back to what we own. Because that's a fake sense of self-esteem. It's interesting, the Holy Quran, the story of Qarun, is a very beautiful story. Allah talks of Qarun. Qarun lived in the time of Musa alayhi salam, and Allah says that we gave Qarun وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ, we gave him treasures, such an amount of treasure and fortune that the keys to that room or to that locker where the treasure was, the keys had to be carried by people of strength. That's how much Qarun owned. And people came to Qarun. His qawm, his people came to Qarun. It says, قَالَ لَهُ قَوْمُهُ لَا تَفْرَحْ قَالَ لَا تَفْرَحْ. Don't puff yourself up. Don't think you're important. Don't become happy because of what you own. Don't think that because of what you own right now, your worth is great. Your value is great. Don't build this image of yourself because of what you own. You know what Qarun said? Look at what Qarun said. قال إنما أوتيته على علم عندي. So what are you talking about? I got all this from my own knowledge. I was a smart guy in business. I did it. I earned this. This is mine. It was my efforts, my long hours, my hard work, my smartness, my tricks in the business that made me achieve all this greatness and fortune. It's from my own ilm. Is that worth anything? It's not worth anything. It's not worth anything. This is a fake self-esteem. This is a fake image that is an imaginary image that does not hold any value. So the Quran says, أَوَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحْلَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنَ الْقُرُونِ مَنْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُ قُوَّةً وَأَكْثَرُهُ جَمْعًا. Doesn't he know? Doesn't he realize how many people before him we've destroyed? People have come and gone who owned more than him? How can you measure your worth based on how much you own? It's sad because I'm trying to emphasize this more and more because it's something we've grown up thinking like this. Just this afternoon, I was just Googling, how much is this person worth? And you find out the answer. What do you mean, how much this person is worth? And it comes a figure in dollars. You see how we're trained, this is how we're trained to think. And social media and influencers doesn't help. In fact, very interesting, studies suggest that 60%, 50 to 60% of social media users have low self-esteem. Majority of people who frequently use social media have low self-esteem, lack in self-esteem. Why? Because what do you see on social media? You're portrayed with an image of what gives worth, material, possession, body image. Body image, that if you were to look like this, if this is how you were to dress, this is how your hair would look, or your clothes, or your body shape, then you'll be worth it. You would gain worth. And what does this lead to? A fake sense of worth, a self-esteem that has no value. So, the first point is career, work, should not become part of our identity, should not never be the source of our self-image. Two, what we own and what possessions that we have, any material thing that we own, cannot give us worth, cannot be a source of the image that we build of ourselves. And three, and this is interesting, in fact, no zahir blessing, no apparent blessing, should lead us to think and to have a self-worth through this. Let me give a beautiful story over here. Inshallah, we'll end with this story. It is reported that Ahmad Bazanti, one of the companions of the 8th Holy Imam, he says, myself and Safwan and Muhammad ibn Sinan and a few other companions, we were in the presence of Imam Ridha alayhi salam. This is a very beautiful story. There's so much you can say about this story, so cherish it. So he says, we're sitting in the presence of Imam Ridha alayhi salam, and we're having a discussion. Just think about this. Just think about it. Just sitting with the Imam at his house, talking about different things. After some time, we got up. We told the Imam we have to leave. So they asked permission to leave. They all got up. Imam Ridha turns to Bazanti and says, Ahmed, you sit down. You sit down. Ahmed says, okay. So he sits down. All the other friends, Safwan and Muhammad ibn Sinan and all the others, they leave. And Imam Ridha and Ahmad Bazanti, they're all alone now in the house of Imam Ridha. Wow. And he says, we had a conversation, we talked about different things. Sometimes you wonder, imagine if we were in the presence of the Imam, what kind of conversation we would have? That should lead us, motivate us to study a bit more. So at least we have something to say to the Imam, some level of conversation we can maintain with the Imam. But it also requires a lot of self-worth and image, positive image of ourselves. So Ahmed is having a conversation with the Imam, and it becomes late at night. So he tells the Imam, it's become late, allow me to go back home. So the Imam tells him, how about you stay over for the night? Would you like to stay over for the night? Now Ahmed is he tries to maybe control his excitement. He tells the Imam, whatever you say. If you tell me to stay, I'll stay. So the Imam tells him, stay. And he places him in a room, and the Imam goes out for a bit, maybe to get something for him. As soon as Ahmed is alone, he goes into sajda. He thanks Allah. He says, Allah, thank you so much for this opportunity that you have granted me, and that you have preferred me over my friends, that they left and I stayed behind. So he's in sajda saying thank you to Allah like this, and he realizes somebody is near me. So he gets up. He gets up and he sees the imam is next to him. The imam looks at him and he holds his hand. He holds his hand tight. He says, "Ya Ahmed, Amirul Mu'mineen once went to visit Sa'd ibn Suhan whilst he was ill." Sa'sa is one of the greatest companions of Amirul Mu'mineen. He says, Amirul Mu'mineen, when Sa'sa was ill, he went to visit Sa'sa ibn Suhan. And as he visited him and he left, he told Sa'sa ibn Suhan that, "Oh Sa'sa, don't count yourself greater over your brothers just because I came to visit you today." In other words, even if you have the opportunity, and we all hope for this opportunity and wish for this opportunity to be in the presence of the imam, even this, as an apparent blessing, should not be the source of your self-esteem. And so the question comes, what is the source of self-esteem? What are the things that I can use to build this izzatun nafs, this positive image of myself? And I can inculcate this in my children as well. I want my children to have high hopes and aim high in their lives, achieve great results. So how do we build this self-image of ourselves? How do we build this self-esteem? And that is a question we should look at tomorrow, inshallah. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are blessed with a fast that is accepted, du'as that are accepted, and that we're able to, inshallah, build ourselves in a way that we have a strong izzatun nafs from the right sources. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the hasten of the reappearance of the 12th Holy Imam and that we are included amongst his loyal companions with the salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.